let's move forward. So now we are going to start with our next topic, that is gender. Okay, we've discussed numbers, now we will be moving on to gender. So now when we talk about gender, it is basically classified into four categories, namely masculine gender, feminine gender, common gender and neuter gender. Yes, you're right. So let's move on. Now this is a table which will actually prove very helpful to you guys, so you can pause and also you can just listen to it carefully. This is a very helpful one. So let's read one by one. Now what about the masculine gender? Yes, the male noun is called the masculine gender. Example, boy, husband, tiger, lion, etc. So all the male genders fall under the category of masculine gender. Feminine gender, all the female genders again. Let me read it for you. The female noun is called feminine gender. Example, girl, wife, tigress, etc. or lioness. Okay? So now, moving on. Common gender and neuter gender. These are the genders where people find most of the difficulty or the confusion between what is a common gender, what is a neuter gender. Okay? So, but I hope by the end of this video, you will have no such doubts regarding common gender or neuter gender. Okay, so now before moving on to common gender, let's just think about it. What do you mean by the word common? Yes, common means something that is common to both of them. So now here means common that it could either be a male gender or it could be a female gender and it is not known to you. Okay, for example, you're asking me, mom, where are you going? I say that I'm going to visit a friend of mine. So if I talk about a friend, now you don't know whether the friend is a male or a female. So in this case, it will fall under the category of common gender, whereby you cannot tell whether it's female or it's a male. Okay, you say that, ma'am, I have an appointment with the doctor. So by this statement, by your word doctor, I know that you're going to visit a doctor, but I don't know whether the doctor is a he or a she, whether it's the masculine gender or it's the feminine gender. So I will put the word doctor under the heading common gender. Okay, so it's clear. Let us read. The noun that refers to both male and female is called common gender. For example, teacher, okay, friend, doctor, teacher, student, etc. Okay, if I say my student love to learn English, so in students, all the male students as well as the female ones. Okay, let's move on to the neuter gender. Now, there are some things that you cannot classify as male or female. If I talk about this pen, can you classify whether it is a male or a female? If I talk about this board, can you classify whether it's male or female? No, you cannot. So in the things whereby you cannot classify as male or female, these are termed as neuter gender. And mostly they include the non-living things. Okay, so let's read. The nouns which are non-living things and cannot be categorized as male or female are called neuter gender. Okay, for example, toy, pencil, book, or you can say a box, lunchbox. Okay, so these are some examples of neuter gender. I hope that this topic is clear to you, and we'll be meeting up in our next video. Until then, take care.